Good evening. Bus, rail and tube fares in the region are going up by around 7% in the new year. Transport managers say the increases are vital to get them out of their cash crisis, but commuters have reacted angrily.
Thames News can confirm that bus, tube and rail fares are set to rise by 7% in January. With trains and buses being axed to save money, the news has sparked an angry reaction from passengers.
I mean, it's expensive enough now for the service we get.
Oh, it's disgusting. It's terrible.
7% fares rise in January. What do you think about that?
It's typical. This is the worst service I've ever met.
The rise will mean single bus and tube journeys going up by between 10 and 20 pence. A 90 pence minimum tube fare in central London is on the cards. An annual three-zone travel card could rise by £40, the Guildford to London season ticket by more than £100. Meanwhile, plans have been announced to fit six-foot-high screens to some stations to stop people falling on the track or committing suicide. They'll have doors which open and close when trains are in the platform, like this shuttle train at Stansted Airport. The Jubilee line extension is expected to be fitted with the screens first. Other lines could follow.
More specialists have been called in at St Bartholomew's Hospital to help treat the boxer Michael Watson, whose condition appears to have worsened slightly. The hospital says the pressure within his head has increased and his brain is swollen. There have been calls for boxing matches to be suspended as a mark of respect for Watson. But they've gone unheeded, and Christopher Rainbow reports on a title bout taking place tonight at Basildon in Essex.
Barry Hearn, promoter of the Eubank Watson fight, has decided that he would go ahead with tonight's super middleweight contest between Slugger O'Toole and Ian Strudwick at Basildon's Festival Hall. This is in spite of calls by some in the boxing world that it should be postponed as a mark of respect for Michael Watson.
I think it's insensitive to run a boxing show at this time, and it isn't just tonight's show. I mean, we have a major promotion coming up at the Royal Albert Hall next week, the European and British heavyweight title fight, Lennox Lewis, Glenn McCrory. I think that similarly could be postponed.
Nevertheless, preparations in the Basildon Hall did go ahead as scheduled for tonight's fight, as the fans turning up for the bout thought they should.
Yes, I reckon it's right, yeah. It's a sport that's been going for ages, so they're all tough boys, aren't they? I mean, they can all handle themselves.
Watson knew the risk, didn't he? I mean, he come out and done a fight, didn't he? But he knew the risk. It's the same with everyone. It's like rugby, isn't it? Like they say on the telly about rugby. It's all the risk, and that's the way it is.
A man has been charged in connection with an incident in which a 10-year-old boy was crushed against the wall of a pub by a car. Daryl Annetts is still seriously ill in hospital with fractured legs and crush injuries. He was hurt in the car park of the Carousel pub at Reading on Saturday night. Thames Valley Police say a 26-year-old man will appear in court in the morning. 150 people have been evacuated from a fire at a tower block in southeast London. The fire is understood to have started in a fifth-floor maisonette in the 11-storey building at Eugenia Road in Rotherhithe. The fire brigade says all of the tenants haven't been accounted for and a search is continuing. The cause of the fire is being investigated. A bomb hoaxer who brought terror to a crowded hamburger restaurant at Victoria Station 2 weeks after the station was bombed by the IRA has been jailed for 9 months. Southwark Crown Court was told that Roger Lonk Clark from Blackheath in South London threw a briefcase among tables at the station's McDonald's restaurant. He shouted, "It's your turn." He was arrested by British Transport Police taking their meal break there. Sentencing him, Judge Marcus Arnwell Davis said Lonk Clark, who denied carrying out the hoax, had instilled fear totally unjustifiably in innocent people. Tower Hamlets Council has begun a campaign against illegal advertising hoardings in the borough. The council, one of the first in London to take a direct approach, says it's been forced to act because going through the courts doesn't work.
These hoardings in Bow may look legal, but they went up less than 6 months ago, almost overnight, without planning permission. Tower Hamlets Council is fighting back with some advertising of its own to alert both the public and the agencies who book the space that they shouldn't be there. The council's taking legal action to force companies to take down 20 illegal hoardings, but that can take more than a year. The council says it's a problem that's spreading across London and tougher laws are needed to stop it.
The powers we have are really inadequate. I would much prefer to see stronger powers, tougher powers, to seek a quicker removal, possibly within a 12-week period as opposed to a 12-month period, and that, if possible, the powers could be extended to take action against the multinational companies that actually advertise on the hoardings themselves.
Now, football. There have been mixed fortunes for London clubs playing their first games in the second round of the Rumbelows League Cup. First Division West Ham were held to a 1-1 draw by Third Division Bradford. And Watford went down 1-0 at Everton. But QPR beat Hull 3-0. And Third Division Leighton Orient had a 0-0 draw with cupholders Sheffield Wednesday. But First Division Wimbledon lost 2-1 at home against Third Division Peterborough. Meanwhile, Third Division Brentford had a home tie against Second Division Brighton. Brentford took a 6-minute lead through Kevin Godfrey. They went further ahead 8 minutes later when Richard Cadet rounded the Brighton keeper. The lead became 3-0 in the 28th minute when Dean Holdsworth fired home. Holdsworth scored again after 57 minutes. John Robinson pulled one back for Brighton, but Brentford held out for a 4-1 win. In the Thames weather, tonight's cloudy and dry, though there may be occasional showers in the east. The temperature about 10 degrees Celsius, that's 50 degrees Fahrenheit. Tomorrow, starting cloudy with showers in the east. It'll become brighter with some sun, though rain could return later. The high 17 Celsius, 63 Fahrenheit. And that's the Thames News on Tuesday, the 24th of September. Good night.
We won our game fair and square.
I did it for Wales.
That's just cheating! Lost the game!
The match will be replayed this year at Cardiff Arms Park.
The teams will remain as they were in 1966.
National pride at stake and old scores to be settled on the field tomorrow at 8 on ITV.
Wales expects.
Still plenty of showers up this western side, and as we go through the day you'll find that more of those showers tending to nudge their way inland. Still some of the heaviest ones though tending to be in the north and the west. Temperatures tomorrow, well, generally speaking, not too different from what we've seen today. 13 to 16, 55 to 61 degrees Fahrenheit about sums it up. But with much less wind generally, it'll probably feel a little bit more comfortable. That's it from me for tonight. Here's the sunset times for tomorrow, and here's the summary.
With recent years seeing the collapse of communism in Europe and the spread of the Western way of life across the world, Legacy after the break explores some of the achievements and disasters of Western civilizations.
Thank you.
On Thames Television Now, Michael Wood presents the last in the series of Legacy.